get loose and produce.
Hello, my beautiful friends. Welcome. I'm your host, Papa Long Dick. Today I'm going to break down a sound from one of our songs called Crash Test. Here it is. So we had a couple people ask about the leading drop sound of the song, so I figured I'd break it down for you guys. So the sound itself is a very simple patch. It consists of three oscillators, a noise oscillator, and some effects. Oscillator A is a sine wave being modulated by oscillator B, which is also a sine wave, which is getting frequency modulated by the noise oscillator, which is set to a symbol loop. There's also a sub oscillator going through the effects and out to the chain. There's a filter, which is a band reject, which is giving a bit of drive and filtering out a transient. Let me show you how each element sounds on their own. I'm going to turn off all the effects. So obviously the sound is not lit, but when we were thinking about the actual sound that we wanted to make, we knew that we wanted a high-pitched, hyphy sound. So after hearing this, I figured that we should add some frequency modulation to give it some movement. Now it's 5 octaves down because the lower the octave, the lower the frequency, the slower the wave is. So by lowering it by 5 octaves, this movement that this sine wave is giving to this other sine wave is much slower. So watch, I'm going to turn up the octave and it's going to be faster. I thought that this low octave sounded the best. Now, it still sounds too clean and not harmonically rich. At this point, I added a noise oscillator to frequency modulate oscillator B, and this is gonna break up this perfect sine wave into these little peaks, which is then gonna go into this oscillator A and mess it up some more. So you can hear that noisy texture right there. Now, at this point, I figured I'd distort it. It still wasn't giving me enough mid-range presence. This is a trick that I often use. I set a sub-oscillator to run with these oscillators, and then I set a low-cut filter in post. And now these harmonics that are being sent in to this distortion unit, they're also going to be affected, and they're going to spread in the spectrum, and it's going to make the sound feel richer and bigger. I hate showing tutorials where I'm gonna be telling you percentages and where to put things. I recommend just playing around with different sounds, different wave tables, and just discovering something cool. Copying a tutorial only gets you so far. Now after we got the foundation down, I went and I distorted the mid-range a little bit. I used a warm tube and I drove it. In hindsight, I should have used these tone faders to get a better sound, but finally, I added a very unconventional reverb with a small room and a pretty low mix, and we got a cool space for the sound. Now what we did next is that we sampled it out and used the sample for the final product. So what we did is we took the sample that we just made and we chopped it up, added some pitch animation with some volume ducking, and that's it. Anyway, I hope you found that helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments, and peace out.